How to implement bubble sort in C#. Bubble sort is an in-place sorting algorithm, so it takes constant space. It is also a stable sort. For bubble sort's best case, it is big omega of n. This occurs when the list is already in sorted order, and so bubble sort will only do n comparisons and zero swaps. The average case for bubble sort is big theta of n squared, because it will perform n squared swaps and n squared comparisons. The worst case for bubble sort is big O of n squared, because it will take n squared swaps and n squared comparisons. So here's an example array of doubles. We will pass that array into our bubble sort method. Here's our bubble sort method. Basically, bubble sort takes a number in the array and moves it to the end of the array. So it goes to each index and compares to the next number. If that number is greater than the next number, then they are swapped. So the next largest number moves all the way to the right on each pass, with the last position being shrunk on each pass. Here we have a temporary variable used to swap items in our list later. Here we have a loop that goes from 0 to the length of the list minus 1. We loop through 1 less than the length of the array because we are comparing to the number after the current number. Thus, we do not need to go to the last position as there will be no further number after it. So now I is the current position we solve for from the right. So essentially we add I to not go to the last element as the element has already been moved to the right. We do this in our inner loop. So each time we go from 0 to the length of the array minus 1 plus I from the outer loop. So we subtract from the end of the array after each iteration of the outer loop, because on each iteration of our outer loop, we have moved a number all the way it can go right. So here inside our inner loop, we essentially take the position j and compare it to j plus 1. So we check if the previous number is greater than the next number. And if the previous number is greater than the next number, then inside of the if condition, then we swap those numbers. For example, on the first iteration, 36 is greater than 2. So we need to swap those numbers. So we put 2 in our temporary variable. Then we move 36 into the position where 2 was before. And then we put 2 in the position where 36 was. On the next iteration, 36 will be swapped with 29. Then 36 will be swapped with 1. And eventually, 36 will be at the end of the list. So as we iterate through our outer loop, our I will increment 1, and so we will not look at position 5 in the list now. And we will go through again from 0 to 4. As we go through again, I is now equal to 1. So we will not look at the last index in our array now, because we subtract 1 and we subtract I. 36 is at position 5, and now we will look through 0 through 4 of our array. And 29 will be moved to position 4. As we go through again, 2 will be swapped with 1 and our list will be sorted. As of now, our entire list is sorted, but we will continue to go through the rest of the array, looping through for every index of I. Here's the example of the swaps of this array where 36 went to the end of the list, then 29 went to the second position to the end of the list, and then 2 went forward one position and found it was not greater than 8, so it stayed in that position. And that's about it for the implementation of bubble sort in C#. If you like this video, please give it a like and a comment below. If you'd like to see more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel. If you want to keep up to date with my latest videos, hit the notification bell, and thank you for watching.